Hello and welcome back. In today's video, we'll be learning how to create different designs, typically on the side, on the plane side of the bottle and also on the curved side of the bottle. So we'll start with the plane side first, okay, and we'll technically understand how to create different types of designs onto the bottle itself. Now what I want to do is I want to create a traditional wave pattern, okay, onto the side of the bottle. And technically there are some spaces for labeling which I don't want to keep for now because I'm just creating a bottle without a label. Okay, so I just want to keep that entire, you know, design to be continued throughout the bottle. So what I want to do first of all is I need to go to the command called curve, or in the curve tab we need to go to this particular command called offset curve in face. And this particular command will help you to create a lot of designs. Now if you haven't watched my video in which I have created a stepped bowl, that same technique can be used over here in order to create this particular part. Now what I'll do is I'll click on offset and face. Here I'll just reset the command so that for all of us the command is the same. Now here in curve, I'm going to select a single curve, that is this curve here. Okay, and in the face category, I'm going to select a single face, which is this face over here. If the arrow is pointing up, I need to click on the flip button so that it points down. Okay, and then I want to provide the offset value. For example, if I provide the offset value of 10, this is how it's going to look like. Now I want to spare some space on the top so that I can create some different designs on the top. So what I'm going to do is I'm planning to keep this particular, the first value itself a little below. So let's say I'll keep it at 20. Okay, so here I have created an offset of this curve on this face at a distance of 20. Now mind me, this particular option will work for almost all the type of bottle you're creating. It can be a flat bottle, it can be a curved bottle. Okay, because if you have watched my video of stepped cube, you will understand the procedure which we are going to use to create this bottle will work on almost everything. Now, again, I'm going to use this command called point set. I'm going to select this curve. This time, obviously, we don't want that 19 ups and downs. Okay, so I want 6 ups and 6 downs, you can say. So I'll just give 13 over here, which will be too close, I guess. Okay, so let's say we'll settle for 3 ups and 3 downs. Okay, so I'll just keep it 7 over here. So that way we total have 6 points, okay, if I enter 7 over here, we have total of 6 points and each point will represent the up and down value. Now here I'll click OK. Now before we continue, again we'll go to expressions, I'll press Ctrl E and go to expression, and this time you might find a fairly, you know, long list of values over here in expression. This is all because of the previous command which we have used, which was known as edge blend, and inside that we have created variable radius. Okay, so for this particular example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create two more expressions. I've already created an expression called A and B, and I've already defined the value for both of them. Now for now, I'm going to create one expression called, let's say, D1. So that is distance 1, or DIST1. I'll just type DIST1 and DIST2. Now I want my distance 1 to be of 5 and distance 2 also to be of 5. Same like the way we did for A and B. Okay, I'll click OK, and here in user expression list, now we have distance 1 and distance 2. Now what I'm going to do next is, I'm going to click on this command called offset curve in face again. Then this time, I'm going to use this option called variable. In place of constant, I'm going to use variable. In the selection of curve, this is the curve which we are going to select. In the selection of face, this is the face which we are going to select. And here in law type, okay, in law type, I'm going to choose cubic along spine. Now here in location, I'm going to select the point, and again, to select the point properly or precisely, I'll go to the snap dialog, and here I'll deactivate all the snap points except for this option called existing point. This way it will be easier for me to actually select an existing point. Okay, so for example here, this particular point will be the first point for the location. You can see in list point 1, and again note that if you select the point in order, it will be easier. So now point 2 is selected, now point 3 is selected, now point 4 is selected, now point 5 is selected, and now point 6 is selected. Now because there are less number of points, it will be easier for us to manage the data. Okay, now the first point will have a value of distance 1. Okay, so it will have a value of distance 1. The second point will have a value of distance 2, and this is going to repeat. Okay, the first point again will have a value for distance 1, and the next point will have a value for distance 2. So it's fairly simple than the one which we created in the bottom. Okay, similar technique I'm using. So again, distance 1, and finally over here, distance 2. Now I am using this technique because this saves a lot of time in future. If I want to change any of the parameters, I just need to simply change the value for distance 1 and 2, and technically all the parameters related to this curve will be changed. Now once I'm done with this, I can click OK. I know it is not a curve pattern as of now, What I can do is I can change the value for distance 1 and 2. For example, here, distance 1 is 5 and distance 2 is 5. I can just try to make distance to minus 5. And now you can see that my design is looking much proper. Okay, so now my distance 1 is 5, which is going up by 5, and distance 2 is minus 5. And because it is cubic along spine, it is a very smooth geometry. Now I'll hide the offset, also the point set, so that I can have a cleaner look on what kind of curve I have just managed to create. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to click on this option called surface, or the tab called surface, and then I'm going to click on more and going to go for the command called tube. And I have already created a detailed video on how to use the tube command. If you haven't watched that video, I would recommend you to go and watch the video on how to use the tube command. Again, if you are coming from a version where the tube command is not located here, okay, you will find it under the home tab, more group, and here you will find the tube command somewhere. Okay, so here in the surface tab, anyone who is using NX12 and above, they will find the command over here in the surface tab, in the more group, and you will find the tube command here. Now let's say I want to give the tube a diameter of 7. I'll see what exactly how it's going to look like. I'm going to select this geometry, boolean set to none. I'm just going to see the result. Now 7 looks appropriate, but it is too big for my liking. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it 5. So now here this looks almost perfect. Now make sure the outer diameter is 5, inner diameter is 0, boolean is set to none, and in setting it is selected to single segment. If you are resetting the command, make sure all the settings are correct. And now I'll click OK for the tube to be created. Now I'll hide my offset curve in face command, and now I have to create a pattern of this, okay, so that it fills the entire length of the portal. For doing that, I'll go to the home tab, I'll click on the more group and choose this option called pattern geometry. Now while choosing pattern geometry, here I'm going to use the linear category of pattern, that is a linear pattern itself. I'll reset if you want. I can select this object. Here in vector, I'm selecting the downward vector, okay, and currently I'm getting a copy at a distance of 10. Okay, and I hope this is good. So what I'll do is I'll make it 8 copies, which is going fairly close to the bottom part. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll make 7 copies instead of 8. I'll just increase the distance by 1 or 2 mm. Okay, so let's say 11 mm is the distance and 7 is the number of copies what I have just created. Okay, now it is looking like a bottle wearing that particular shape. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to now click on subtract. Okay, initially I didn't subtract it. There is a reason for that. You will understand now. So here I'm going to select this as my target body. And in tool body, I'm just going to press Ctrl A to select all the bodies as my tool body. And now everything got subtracted at once. Okay, now it is faster. Why? Because the command which I'm going to use right now. For example, here I'm going to go for edge blend. I want a radius of 5 at a feature intersection edges. So here in the curve rule, I'm going to select feature intersection edges. And I'm going to select the subtract command from the tree. Now what the command will do is, or what the software will do is, it will apply fillet of radius 5 to all the edges which was created by the subtract command itself. So I want a fillet of radius 3 instead, and here I'll click OK. Now you can see this kind of design is almost ready. Okay, now if you're not happy with the radius, you can just simply go back to the value of edge blend and you can change it. Let's say I'll make it 2 mm again, and this is how it's going to look like. Okay, if you're not even happy with the up and down value, you can change this values as well. So here I can make it 3 up. Okay, and you can see everything is getting updated. Okay, now it is looking much better. And here I can make, let's say, minus 2 down, a little less down. Okay, so you can see different types of designs will come or generate automatically as you simply change the value over here. Okay, now I hope this particular part is understood. Now what I'm going to do next is, I'm going to create some designs on this curved part. Okay, so let's say I am quite, good with the design which is related to the slice bottle. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a sketch on any front plane or side plane, and here I'm going to create a line. So let's say my line will be an angular line like this. Okay, so it's a simple line which I'm creating just for the sake of dimensioning it. I'm defining a dimension, let's say from here to here the distance will be 10, and from here to the center of this bottom edge again the distance will be 10. Okay, so I'm keeping both the distance of 10. From here again to the center, I'll keep this 10. Okay, so that it extends and goes, outside the particular bottle. Or I can even make it more, like I can make it 15. Okay, so that it will be easier for me to manage. And from here to here, this gap, again, I want to increase this. So I'll just try 25. Okay, 25 is looking good. And I'll just make it 30. 30 is going too much. So what I'll do, I'll reduce it by 2 mm. Let's say 28 or 27 would be better for this case. So I created a slant line in which the top particular point is distance like 15 and 10 mm apart, and the bottom point is distance at 10 mm and 27 mm apart. Now, I'm going to close the command. I'm going to click on finish. And I'm going to select the line. Then go to the curve tab and click on project curve command. So make sure the line is already selected or the sketch containing the line is already selected. Now I'll click on project curve command. And here I'm going to select the face and I'm going to make sure it is on single face selection rule. So I'm going to select the single face. The direction will be exactly in front of the line. Okay, so this is how I want to project it. And make sure projection option is not set to project both sides, because otherwise it will happen on both the sides. So I'll just keep it on none. And here I'll click OK. And this is how my projection is going to look like. Now what I'm going to do is, with the help of this particular projection, I'm going to create a tube command for me. So here I'm going to go to the surface tab, again going to the more group, clicking on tube command, selecting this geometry itself and seeing like the radius of eye is looking good enough for this particular geometry. I'll just reduce it to 4mm for now. Okay. And this is how the tube is going to look like. Okay. Now, if I subtract it right away, okay, I will be not happy with the results what I'm getting, because it is like flattened at both the ends. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, rather, I'm going to click on this command called offset, and here I'm going to select this face, the flat face. I'm going to offset it, let's say by 20 mm, and I'm going to offset this face as well along with it by 20 mm. Now this way both the faces will have a smooth entry and smooth exit out of that particular portal. Now, before I click on subtract, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pattern this multiple times, and before that I'm going to use mirror geometry. Now, while using mirror geometry, I'm going to select this particular feature or this particular geometry to be mirrored, and in mirror plane I'm going to select the YZ plane or XZ plane. So I want a mirror to look like this. Okay, so you can take your time and you can create a mirror which looks almost like this. Okay, now once my mirror geometry is ready, then I'm going to click on pattern geometry. I'm going to select both the geometries here, so geometry number 1 and geometry number 2. I'm going to opt for circular pattern. Okay, and here in vector I'm going to select the Z axis. Now here I'm going to say count and span of 360 degree, and obviously I don't want 12 copies, I want only 6 of them for viewing. So I'll just have 6 copies first and I'll click OK. Now this is how the entire design is looking for now. Okay, so if I'm happy with the design, I can continue working on it. Okay, if I'm not happy, I can, if I want to reduce the spaces or something, I can just simply increase the number. Let's say in place of 6, I will make it 10, so that the density is increased fairly to a good amount. Okay, now what I want to do next is I want to unite all of these things, okay, together, so that it forms a very good shape. Okay, now to unite them, what I can do, I can I'll just change my mind. I'll just make it 3 or 4 copies for now. Okay, I'll not make much copies. Okay, so I'm making only 4 copies for now, just to introduce simplicity in my design. Now I'll click on unite and I'll unite each one of these. So I'll press Ctrl A and I'll press Shift and deselect this body. So this is my target body, this 7 are my tool body, and I'll now click OK. So this will result in a united shape. Okay, now I'm going to click on edge blend again. Again this option will be set to feature intersection, radius is set to 3, and I'm going to select the last unite which I just did. So it will create a fillet of radius 3 at every unite which I just created. Okay, now it can take a while if the radius is too high for the liking. Okay, for example, here the fillet of radius 3 is too much. So what I'll do, I'll give a fillet of radius 1. Okay, 1, or I'll just try for a bigger value. Okay, if it is possible. So let's say I'm trying for fillet of radius 2, but it is too much. Again, I'll try 1.5. And 1.5 is fairly good. I'll click OK. And now as we can see, my fillets are ready. Okay, now I'll go to subtract, and finally I can select the bottle and subtract this tube geometries out of the bottle. Okay, now again I can go for the edge blend command, again feature intersection, this time the radius I'll set to 1 and select the last subtract tool. So now the software is automatically applying a fillet of radius 1 to all the subtracted edges. I'll just try a higher value, let's say 2, and see the results. Okay, higher the value, better the results. Okay, so I'll click OK now. Okay, and this kind of design is ready. So I hope you understood how to create this type of different designs onto the bottle itself. Okay, now before finishing, I want to create one more small design detail over here, which will increase the look of the bottle. And for doing that, I'm going to select the front plane or the right plane. Okay, then I'm going to choose this option called intersection point. I'm going to select this curve so that I can get an intersection point over here. Now I'm going to create my design. For example, my design will look somewhat like this. like a triangle. So I'm just creating a simple triangle here, making sure both the lines, the angular lines, are equal to each other. So here I'm just making both the lines equal. Now again, one more thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a circle here, okay, at an intersection of these two designs. Now I'll give the parameters. The circle diameter is going to be, let's say, 5 mm. The distance of the circle from the line, this gap, is going to be, let's say, 1 mm. The overall length of the line is going to be, suppose, 10 mm, okay, or 15 mm. 15 will be too much, so I'll make it 12 mm for now, okay. So overall length of the line is going to be 12. Now I'll use the trim tool to get rid of this extra part, okay. So only this part is going to remain. Now I'll click on finish. I'll choose the revolve command, okay. So this is fairly simple design over here. So now the axis is Z axis. I'll choose subtract and I'll click OK. So now this kind of design is also created here in the bottom part. Now what I'll do to make the design looks better, I'm going to choose single curve rule, and I'm going to use the edge blend command. And here, I want to create an edge blend of, let's say, radius 5 or radius 2. And here on the top, again, I want a radius of 2. So if you want, you can create a single edge blend of radius 2. And this is how my design is going to look like overall. Okay, so far I have created this bottle, okay, and this is how this particular part is going to look like so far. So what we are going to do next, in the next video, we are going to understand how to create the neck part of the bottle, okay, the neck part. So before that, I'll just add a fillet here in this video itself. So let's say a fillet of radius 5 would look good over here, okay. So in the next video, we will learn how to create the neck part of the bottle and how to continue or complete the design of the bottle, okay. So thank you very much for watching. Have a great day ahead. And keep watching. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, kindly subscribe to the channel. This will help me a lot. Okay, thank you very much.